everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. Both defenses will have to be on the watch for a pair of tight ends looking to find seams in the secondary. It's the Rams going up against the Panthers. With that, we head up to Charlotte, where we'll hook up with our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis at Bank of America Stadium. Gentlemen.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Los Angeles Rams and the Carolina Panthers. Hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we saw Larry focus on the tight end matchup in his open. You think it's one to watch, don't you?
Definitely one to watch because these guys can create such big plays by all the different things they can do. Line up out wide, in the slot, line up in a normal tight end position, and then who are you going to cover them with? Is it a linebacker, a defensive back? They create mismatches all throughout the game.
The kicker, Graham Gano, set to put his foot into this one. And off we go from uptown Charlotte. Now the return man, this is Benny Cunningham. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line.
Here we go now. Blue line.
They'll start out on the ground with Gurley. And this defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. And this offense certainly hoping that a veteran wide receiver in Britt can set the tone here in this one.
And we've seen better maturity out of him as his career has gone on, but no lack of speed. He can still get deep and hurt a defense.
And on second and 10 now.
Here we go now. Boom, landing.
A play fake to Gurley. Now gone. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that's caught inside the 35. It's a big conversion there for the Rams on third down. 42 yards. And now a first down following that long gain.
Today's receivers in the NFL, they're the complete package nowadays. We know they can run. We know they can catch. But they have those big frames now. So oftentimes they just out-physical guys downfield and go up and catch the football. And we saw a big gain as a result on that play.
Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down.
Set. Green, 39.
Back to the air. Goff on second down. Unable to connect there on the pass play. Defense has set themselves up nicely. Third and 10 now.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39.
They go play action with Gurley. Now Goff. He's got time. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Star Latulele coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it'll be fourth down.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
So the flag is for roughing the kicker, a big 15-yard penalty.
And I'm not sure that was the time to go all out after the kicker. Plenty of time left in this game.
Following the penalty, it's Gurley. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. And here comes play number 6 on this drive.
Charles Johnson's stock in trade is coming off the edge and getting to the quarterback. He knows how to make some of those subtle moves inside to help in the run game, and he did it right there.
He's an athlete back in high school, played football, basketball, track, so he's a mobile guy.
Mobile guy, made a nice play against the run. Well, that's the big drawback to this play. Even if somehow the quarterback pitches it, he's not immune to the big hit. In this case, he kept it and absorbed it anyway.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Finding time. all kinds of time. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. Now it's Zuerlein to try the Ram field goal. Spotted at the left hash, this from 45. And Zuerlein's kick is good. And the Rams have the first points here. It's 3-0. So our initial drive here this afternoon results in three. I'm not sure that was a statement necessarily, but getting points on the road, never a bad thing.
No question about it, Brandon. You had a crowd that was all fired up during pregame introductions, yet you're able to quiet them just a little bit by taking the early lead.
Here on first down, out to his left. Oh, he's gonna take a shot right away. He's got a man complete. It's a big play there. Newton again. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. On first down, Newton flushed out right. That is caught. Touchdown. Again, 41 yards, and the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Cunningham now to return. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. The Rams offense now making their way out to take over. And last time able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. Big boys down there in the trenches and a nice play to stop them. Pulled. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
And he'll be taken. Back live now to begin the second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden. It's the Rams with a football to get us going, and they've got it here with a first down.
Let's go! 3-19!
On first down, gone. That's complete to his tight end. This is Lance Kendricks. Give him six on the play, and that'll make it second down. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. They come up in an offset eye. Now on second down, this is Gurley. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line.
That play never got off the ground because of the defensive front. They owned the offensive line, which allowed the linebackers to see their openings and run straight to the ball. That's why that play just never had a chance.
He's got time in the pocket. So he couldn't find his man there as it falls to the ground. So the Rams call on Johnny Hecker here to punt it away on fourth down. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. Getting set to go again here. Cam Newton marches back onto the field. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let them know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back with more from Charlotte after this. Back now as I search for my cue card here. There we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis from our first half of play.
Well, Rez.
Well, thank you.
Looked like the screen pass was taken away there, and that was a nice job of improvising, but it's not normal. Usually when a screen pass is taken away, you're taught to just throw the ball at the ground at the feet of the receiver so that you don't get it intercepted and just start over. But he ended up finding another receiver.
Now it's Newton. And caught left side, Olsen. And down inside the 15 he goes. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves his sticks.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Second and 10, Newton. So they're unsuccessful there, hooking up on the pass.
Well, I haven't met a quarterback yet that doesn't like a target that size. I mean, that's a big, tall receiver, and somehow he missed him anyway.
Yeah, tempting to just put it out there for him to go get it, but dangerous throw and not on target.
Yeah, sometimes even a receiver with that type of catch radius can't haul them in if they're not accurate.
And almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's fourth down. So now off goes Newton, and on comes the kicker, Graham Gano. And Gano's kick is right through. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So they were able to move the ball into the red zone, but they'll wind up coming away with just three.
Yeah, 32-yarder. That's equal to an extra point nowadays, and those are no problem for an NFL kicker.
This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Come out throwing here on first down. This one caught left side by Cooper. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and it'll be second down. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
Hurry up, here we go. Green 39. Green 39.
Here's Goff now on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. And the offense needs 7 out of this play on third down.
Leppard! Leppard!
Throwing on third. Goff. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. Now it's Gim. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. Here's the defense for Los Angeles as they head out to set up shop. And they did well down near the goal line last time, forcing him to settle for a short field goal.
And in today's day and age, settling for a field goal of that distance, it's amazing. You can get 3 points now, where it's going to give you only 1 point for the extra point, which would be a little bit longer. But they have to feel fantastic about only giving up 3 in that situation. It could have been so much worse.
Yeah, could have. Now can they carry that over? Now Newton. That is caught. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. So it's halftime here in Charlotte with the Panthers out on top. As we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. Both teams have had their moments so far today, and that's why we have a tight game on our hands. We'll have to see if either side can take control in the second half. So here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Rams taking the field for their opening drive. Latulele's got the sack here, and he'll end up at the 40-yard line before being tackled. Now first and 10, Newton's on target here, and the pass and catch will end up going for 41 yards. Later on the drive, here's Cam Newton scrambling away and completing the pass. And this play will go for 6. So that'll do it for us here in Orlando. For the call of the second half, let's hand it back over to Brandon and Charles. Brandon.
This will be fielded at the 6. And his guys are going to start their drive right at the 20-yard line. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Unable to connect there on the pass play.
And that one was knocked away, and I think the defender's going to be a little upset with themselves. They made the play on the football, but that one felt like a forced pass by the quarterback. Thought he had someone open. He really wasn't. Maybe an example of having too much confidence in his receiver that no matter what, I'm like,
and got his man complete. And it's caught. Touchdown. Ted Ginn. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
As you know, I love the players of the past. But the players of the present and their mobility to move around and play quarterback, we just saw the end result of a guy that can shake it and find a guy open downfield.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. This one taken from the 7. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Out come the Rams. They'll have it first here to begin the third quarter. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like in the half?
Because
that's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker boards?
Yeah, those two.
Back to the ground, this time with Gurley. Fresh set of downs here. Play fake here on first down. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And that's going to make it 2nd and 14. Offense needs something here on second down. It is 2nd and long.
Hurry up, here we go.
To throw on 2nd down is gone. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were. They go play action with Gurley. Now Goff surveying the field. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up 4th. So on now is Johnny Hecker to punt this one away. And there's a flag on the field.
intentional foul. Roughing the kicker. Defense.
Oh, and you just can't do that. 15 yards on the roughing the kicker call.
Absolutely inexcusable. The kicker's in a defenseless position, and he just gets taken out.
Let's go! Green 39! Green 39!
Back to the ground game here. Gurley. And some room to work. There he goes, right side. And all the way in for the touchdown. Todd Gurley, 46 yards. And the Rams have got this back to a one-score game. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. This fielded at the two. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. The Panthers and Cam Newton getting set to go again here on offense. And you think he personally is evaluating his game so far? He was pretty good in the first half, been good so far here in the third quarter. He's got to like it, right?
Not looking for the dramatics here. Not trying to set the world on fire in terms of stats. It's almost like you're driving. Hands at 10-2, alert for anything out there, watching for trouble on the road, and making sure you get the team home.
The bus driver. See if he can drive the bus here again on this drive. They go play action here on first down. Steps away. Now he'll throw deep left side. And oh, what a catch! And he's into the end zone for the receiving touchdown. Devin Funchess, 53 yards. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead.
Partner, one of the cardinal rules of defense is that if you're in position to make a tackle, you need to make it.
Well, and if you can't make the tackle before that, you just got to knock that ball down, right?
Yeah, something has to happen, because we saw the end result there. Missed tackle, he goes all the way and takes it for a touchdown.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. This will be fielded at the six. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The one running back is Gurley. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. So he couldn't find his man there as it falls to the ground. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends.
Here we go. 3-19! 3-19!
Second and 10. Goff again. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And we're back now in Charlotte. It's the Rams trailing, but they do have the football as we start the fourth and final quarter. And I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. Here's Goff. Dumps it off to Gurley. And he will have the first down, but he winds up paying for it pretty good.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
On first down, it's gone. And that's complete to Brian Quick. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Goff on first down. That's complete to his tight end. This is Lance Kendricks. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it's a second down. Second down now after the pass completion.
Here we go now.
Goff throwing again. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. So an excellent throw and an excellent catch there.
Zone coverage, which means you just have to find the open areas in between defenders. That's exactly what happened on that play.
On first down, gone. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. Fourth quarter, two-minute warning about to hit, and it looks like they're going to get one more play in.
Be interesting to see what they try and do on this play. Do they try and take a shot, or do they just try and get to the two-minute warning?
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Throwing on third, Goff. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Desperation time for Goff on fourth. He finds Quick. It'll be a 20-yard gain on the play. And the decision to go for it pays off. They've got a first and goal. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Here's Goff. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. It's a gain of six on the play. And that'll make it second and goal. To throw on second down is Goff. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
Well, the pressure, the hits, the sacks have been coming at him all game long. I'm frankly surprised that they haven't found a solution yet to create more time for him to throw it or maybe change what they do on offense.
And that's one of the biggest differences in this game and why they're losing right now. The field goal doesn't help. They're going to go for the six here on fourth and goal. They'll run for it with Mason. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the six. That'll go as a loss of five. And the Panthers defense able to deliver the goal line stand. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good. Now here's a timeout coming on the defensive side of the ball. It's a six-yard pickup, and it gets them to second and four. See if they stay on the ground for second down. They come out here in the eye. Cam fighting. He lost the football. It's out. They'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's third down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. And they've got an extra defensive back out there now on third and 13. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 5-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. The Panthers going for it on fourth. Newton sliding out of the pocket. He can run for it, and he will. And he is out of bounds just shy of the 20. That'll be a gain of 15 yards. And they're able to move the chains as they convert on fourth and long. The Panthers down to a knee out of the victory formation. And this one going to wrap up with Cam Newton going down to a knee. And with a third and 14, we have six defensive backs out there now defensively. All right, Charles, so you win the game. Not only do you get the W in the left-hand column, you get some momentum for the coming week.
Now when you go into the week and you're telling the guys what mistakes have to be corrected, what we have to do to win going forward, you have their full attention. They're excited, they're happy, and they know if they can build that momentum, they can ultimately achieve all their goals.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaunt. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. The Panthers are winners here as we say so long from Charlotte.